Let's talk about money, making money. In this week's Torah reading of Ki Tetzei, we encounter the prohibition against taking interest on a loan to a fellow Jew. Oh no, there goes our business model. Well, the Torah in the same verse at the end promises reward for not taking that cash cow of easy income called interest. The reward is, L'man yivarechecha Adonai Elohecha b'chol mishlach yadecha al ha'aretz asher ata ba shama l'rishta. So the Lord your God will bless you in all your endeavors on the land which you come to possess. The 19th century commentator, the Malbim, who was a master of Hebrew grammar, he notes that usually the Torah refers to the land as the land which I will give you. But here it refers to the land which you come to possess. That needs explaining. The Malbim says that there's a subtle message here. And to emphasize it, he changes the punctuation of the verse to read like this. God will bless you on the land which you come, comma, to possess. The Malbim explains. Bischar sheheminu bashem uva'u la'aretz, bischar zeh yarshu. The reward for having faith in God and coming to Israel is you will possess it. In other words, you come, you possess. Now comes the knockout punch. The Malbim explains that this teaching is juxtaposed to the prohibition against interest as a hint. You walk away from that tangible income and put your trust in God, He will provide for you from elsewhere. Let's put all of this together. The number one deterrent keeping Jews from coming to Israel tomorrow morning is the very valid question, how will I make a living in Israel? Salaries outside of Israel are often much higher than those in Israel. How can we expect a person to leave a high salary for a lower one, or even put his whole job security at risk? That's very scary and perhaps even irresponsible. The Torah here is addressing that primary concern of diaspora Jews. How will I make a decent living in Israel? The Torah teaches us, just like a Jew who turns his back on interest will merit divine blessing, so too a Jew who walks away from a lucrative business in the diaspora and makes that leap of faith to come to Israel, he too will merit divine blessing.
I'm moving to Israel. I wanted to thank you and say goodbye.
Man, are you crazy? How are you going to make any money? There's not even any jobs there.
Israel's far away, and you don't even speak the language.
You're going to throw it all away, buddy. Everything you know and everything you have.
We need you here, and you can be just as Jewish and still love Israel if you stay. I'll even throw in a raise.
No.
Sometimes divine blessing is not just physical needs, but also the spiritual fulfillment and serenity of putting one's lot and future in God's vineyard and being a part of the Hebrew nation that tends to the vineyard. Your brothers and sisters in Israel will all receive you with love and outstretched arms. But come now, while you can still bring your wealth and your dignity. Hey, click on the link below to subscribe to the Israel National Torah newsletter. With much love, Shabbat Shalom from Beit El.